Hey guys, welcome to music for Thursday, April 23rd. One more day of pretending to be in the music room because I still miss you guys. I still miss being here, but we still got to do what we got to do. And so we're going to review what we've done this week. We have had our elimination going on. We started with Celine Dion and Adele, and I decided that Adele should win that one. And then I had Adele versus Whitney, but I thought Whitney should win. So overall, in our first bracket side, I decided the Beatles was the overall winner. But again, if you're playing along, your decision is your decision because this is all opinion. And then we did the film composers, John Williams versus Hans Zimmer. And John Williams has always been my favorite composer since I'm going to tell you guys how old I am right now, since I first heard the Star Wars films when I was really young in the theater when they first came out. So I, of course, had to pick John Williams. And so far, John Williams is winning on that side. Today, we are going to continue with the film composers. And let's get started with our resource guide today. That is right here. Here we go. Resource composers. You're going to need Thursday, April 23rd. We have Alan Silvestri with the Avengers soundtrack and James Newton Howard with the main title from Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. And then I also in your resource packet put the original elimination for the 16 teams. Not really teams, but it's the best I could find. So you can print this off and fill it in if you want to, or you can just follow along if you want to do that too. And so here we go with our composers for today. And we have Alan Silvestri versus James Newton Howard. They both are about the same age, and they both started composing or playing music really young. Alan Silvestri was born in 1950, and he began composing for film and TV when he was 21. He frequently writes for film director Robert Zemeckis, writing for the Back to the Future trilogy, Who Framed Roger Rabbit, Castaway, and Forrest Gump. He has a two-time Academy Award and Golden Globe Award nominee. He started writing in 1972, but nobody really has ever heard of that movie. But in 1977, he was the main composer for the television series Chips. And then he met Robert Zemeckis and started writing for the movie Romancing the Stone. And then since then, he wrote it for all of Zemeckis's movies since then, including, like I said, the Back to the Future trilogy, Who Framed Roger Rabbit, Death Becomes Her, and like every single other one. He also wrote for James Cameron, The Abyss, and he's also wrote for The Mummy Returns, Van Helsing, G.I. Joe, The Rise of Cobra. The one that we are going to listen to today is The Avengers, and here we go with that. The Avengers. If you want to hear more of that, you can click on the link in your resources. We're going to continue on right now and talking about our other composer, James Newton Howard, who started taking piano lessons at the age of 4. He has scored over 100 films and is the recipient of a ton of awards. His film scores include Pretty Woman, Grand Canyon, The Fugitive, The Devil's Advocate, and like if you can see my paper, he's got well, you can't see it because of my background, a whole big paragraph of a lot of things that he has won and that he has written for. Excuse me. He has collaborated with another one of our composers, Hans Zimmer, on the Dark Knight trilogy. He worked with Peter Jackson composing the score for the remake of King Kong and a lot of other movies that he's worked with. M. Night Shyamalan, The Village, and Kevin Costner's Waterworld, and a bunch of other songs. The interesting thing is that we're going to listen to the main title from Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, which the original parts of some of these themes was written by John Williams when he did the Harry Potter themes. So he had to take some parts of some of that and then rewrite them into new themes, which is kind of interesting when you have to take somebody else's work and do that. So here we go, listening to Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. The Hedwig thing right here. John Williams wrote that. But all the rest of it, that's James Newton Howard. Okay, so you can listen to the rest of that one by clicking on the link in your resource guide too. We have just two more days of our composer or performer March. I know it's not really March. Music Madness. I can't wait to see who you guys keep picking, see who your final winner is, and keep having a great day. And I will talk with you guys later. Bye.